a lawsuit claims coercion and racism at a barbecue chain. This is a hell of a story. Let me put up the picture for a mask, give you the background to this. A South Carolina barbecue chain known for its pro-segregation stance in a landmark 1960s case and its embrace of the Confederate flag in 2000 is facing allegation of racism and sexual harassment by the fired general manager of one of his restaurants. Okay. This is according to a lawsuit filed last week. A black woman who worked at a Maurice's Piggie Park barbecue location in Columbia, the man who ran it, general manager Jeff Harrison, coerced her early last year into a sexual relationship and promises of a raise, which he paid. She says she quit after he grew irate and more threatening when she rebuffed his additional sexual advances. The Associated Press isn't naming the woman because she is an alleged victim of sexual abuse, and we agree. In a separate lawsuit brought last month, Damian Wooden, another black former employee, Wooden contends that Harrison left him racist voicemails, including slurs and threatening to break his jaw after he told Harrison to stop calling and harassing the female employee who quit. The lawsuits, which seek undisclosed damages, accuse the company of negligent supervision and accuse Harrison of intentionally inflicting emotional distress, assault, and battery. This is a statement from the company. A company receptionist told the AP that Maurice's Piggie Park Barbecue had no comment. Its president, Lloyd Bessinger, told ABC Columbia News that the company does not condone or accept any sexual or racial behavior. When I heard of Mr. Harrison's behavior, I fired him imminently, Bessinger said in a statement. We are a local family business that supports the community by providing jobs and great barbecue for 60 years. The company's problematic history. It started, let's go to 1964. In 1964, a waitress at a Piggie Park drive-in refused to take two black customers' order. Owner Maurice Bessinger justified his refusal to serve black customers inside his stores, conveyed through window signs, based on his religious opposition to racial integration. In 2000, Bessinger opposed the South Carolina legislature's removal of the Confederate flag from the dome of the state capitol by flying it outside of all of his restaurants. Okay, so this is the reason the manager believed, hey, I can do these bigoted and racist and sexist things because my boss is one. That is likely the ideology of the management who engaged in this kind of behavior, allegedly. But we shall see. Because at this point, you have two lawsuits. They are congruent in nature. You may have more, especially if this individual was involved in managing others. You may have many more lawsuits. As far as I'm concerned, the response from this particular agency, wholly inappropriate, does not speak to the issue at hand, and does not address the culture that we understand historically exists. All right, Jackson, thoughts here?
Yeah, that definitely is an example of just company culture that festers within any environment and the type of people it attracts and how it enables any employee, whether it's low level or management, to take advantage. And the lawsuit is 100% correct, just in terms of his behavior being purposefully emotionally sadistic, going after people and getting a kick out of them being uncomfortable, especially when it comes to the woman he coerced into having sex with him. Because, you know, when men do things like that, obviously it's about power. It's about feeding your ego, feeling like you're in a position of control, because it's not as if men can't just go somewhere and pay for sex in a variety of ways. Or just get on a dating app and be a decent person. There's so many options. So that's not about sex.
Right.
So this guy clearly is just really a rotten individual who deserves any type of negative attention that's coming his way.
Yeah. So we shall follow it.